It's all gist.
Yeah, giving it to our trust. So maybe this is the Sunday morning we're going to church. Someone is looking very stunning. Ciao, ciao. But we're not seeing your face, basically.
That's the point.
So, peace out. Yeah, you just lose.
Hold on, be very careful.
Wait. I don't understand what you just said.
Did you hear that?
I heard, though. Oh.
When does this discussion start? When we are transitioning from the forces, that's why I said the discussion must start from the forces. When we are transitioning into each season, still for the next season or for the last season we are coming out from, drops, the clothes drop. Like now, we are entering.
Now that we are in spring.
So now that we are in spring, you missed the sale. Sale was in. It's yoga quantity. It's like this. You have to think in terms of how long do you want to use the product or the clothes or whatever you want to buy, how long do you want to use it? Again, I'm dealing with the student-ish kind of mind. So if you're going to be student budgeting, so if you're going to be shopping for, let's say, a semester kind of thing, then you just have 4 months in your mind. Now you have to think in terms of the four seasons, because we operate the four seasons. Yeah. So two things: budget. Of course, you have your budget. That's the foundation of everything. Mm-hmm. Then quality over quantity.
Sure.
Now, quantity depends on the seasons. Okay. So we have spring, we have summer, which are the most beautiful seasons. Then we have winter, and then we have autumn or fall. I just divided it into two things in my mind:
yes.
Cold, warm, the beginning of cold. Like that's easy.
That's brilliant.
I really can't. Yeah. So cold, warm, beginning of cold. Now, we have two semesters. We have from February till July.
Yeah,
February till July, give or take. So February to July is a little bit of cold, beginning of cold or end of cold, and then warm. So you have to plan in that sense. Now for the warmer months, you need to shop for things that you need to shop for quantity as well as quality, but majoring on the quantity. What do I mean by quantity? That means like you get clothes that are called disposables, you know, the Tenari t-shirts,
yeah,
the you know, the tank top,
yeah,
the, you know, not something so, you know,
heavy,
so heavy.
Yeah.
You are not weighing your quality in this point, because hey, it's disposable. Every year like stores are going to keep on stocking up on these things,
kind of.
So you don't really have a lot to think about. You just don't worry. So you get 10 lari, 3 lari, believe you me, there are 3 lari, 10 shirts,
yeah,
and all. H&M will forever get you basics. If you are looking for basics, think H&M. Then there are the special event occasions. Yeah, this one, quantity doesn't really count as much as quality. For special events, depends on the event. So for me, my special event is always Sunday at church, or maybe I'm going on a date
dinner,
or somebody's graduation. Mm-hmm. Graduations are rolling in every semester. Well, every summer semester, they are going to be graduations. So you have to think as a student in terms of quality, meaning you want to wear a cloth that you can wear to a graduation, you can wear it to church, you can decide to wear it to dinner or for a friend's birthday party that is taking place at Radisson. It depends also, believe you me.
Okay.
We have ways around this thing.
Yeah.
So if the birthday party is going to be taking place around the house, you know, you wear a romper or something, or maybe color code. But if it's taking place somewhere important, or maybe her boyfriend is going to propose, or it's marking a significant milestone, you want to tune up your dressing.
Yeah, you
now for that, very good. For that, you have to have the quality. Again, you are a student. You don't have too much money. So just have two things in your mind. If you are the trouser or dress wearing kind of person, then you need to look for a very quality pantsuit. And when I say quality pantsuit, don't go thinking 500 lari, 300 lari, convert that to dollars, whatever you do. You know, you need to be thinking of like, how much centralized shell for that. Maximum 90 lari. Again, it's quality. Okay, it's quality. So again, maximum 90 lari and quality. That's why I said 90 lari. Then you have to have the quantity shell, the quantity things, which are what? Jeans. Jeans are your basic. So I don't make this a video.
It's a video already.
No, like, don't make it the video that we are going to put on. Yeah. Because a whole lot of ideas are coming to my head.
But you need to, we need
have
to chop
to break them. I'll have to work through this video and give you different ideas. So I've spoken about quantity, I've spoken about budget, I've spoken about quantity over quality. Now, there are some things you can skip on. There are high quality jeans. High quality jeans are found in places like Wallis. This is like H&M at a certain time.
What about the Zara?
Is it Zara. Expensive? Zara is, again, quality.
Quality, okay.
Quality. I have bought things in Zara for 12 lari.
Oh, wow.
Yes, believe it. Sugar, you have, I got him trousers for 12 lari.
That was five years ago.
Okay. Yes.
5 years.
But here's the thing. Zara does something which is good and bad. Good in that they look at Fashion Week, which is I'm a student of Fashion Week. They look at Fashion Week, they look at up and coming designers, they nab the idea, they make a cheaper version. That's what they do. Now, cheaper isn't necessarily cheaper, but it's a good price. I mean, instead of me buying a Balenciaga for like $1,000 or something, I would get that same design for less than $50.
Okay. Yeah.
Very good. Now this is where sense comes in. You should buy staples at cheaper places. Then there's this t-shirt, thanks to fashion, the basic t-shirt has been elevated to t-shirt with a flare. We have t-shirts that are tied, you know, for girls. We have t-shirts that have prints on them. We have t-shirts that have puff sleeves. Those are statement t-shirts. But just the basic one of the mill t-shirt, okay? Just get that one at New York. Go to H&M. Go to LC Waikiki. Go to Wells.
Them in New York. New Yorker.
Okay. H&M. LC Waikiki. Those are like your go-to shops here.
Okay, baby. So now we are going into New Yorker.
Yeah, let's go. Thanks.
Is that me there?
See, these are like. Okay, so whatever you do, get a white and get it black. And then you can, once you've gotten those ones, you can do other things. Get white, get black, and get your favorite. Again, we're working on budget. And yet on this kind of thing. Okay, so. This is 8 lari. That's a discount. See, I said 10 lari. This is 8 lari. That's on discount. H&M has shirts for 12 lari round the four seasons.
Okay, no matter what.
No matter what, 12 lari. Now, when discounts are about to start, when does discount start? When we are transitioning from the four seasons. That's why I said the discussion must start from the four seasons. When we are transitioning into each season, sell for the next season or for the last season we are coming out from drops, the clothes drop. Like now that we're in spring, you missed the sale. Sale was in January, February. They were going to have discount on things that were coming out from, like winter things will drop because we are living in winter. The shops don't need to stock up on that. That's one. Then there is a slighter discount on the season we're about to enter into. So now that means September, July, August, September. That's there's two sales seasons. As I said, the whole video has to be divided. There are two seasons. Two shopping seasons.
I think not only Germany, in all of Europe.
So sales seasons are two major sales seasons, July, August, September, massive sales, it's called summer sale. And that's the sale in which all the brand shops and non-brand shops in New Yorker, they are not brand shops, or they are upcoming brand shops. For the sake of not sounding small or something, they are not a well-known brand. So all the brand shops and all the upcoming brand shops will be emptying their stores because they want to bring in new designs that they have made, or they are trying to follow the trend. Good. So that's the massive sale. During this time, you can shop for winter things. You know, we are in summer. July, August, September, that's summer. But you can shop for winter. Winter jackets will be half the price for sure. Whatever jacket you are buying for 100 and something, you will get for 69. You will get for 59. So if you are a student here, you should like keep your money for jackets towards that time. Do not go around buying jackets like, oh, it's cold, I want to buy a jacket. No, you need to be very strategic with it. Unless you have enough money and you can just walk into the shop, which we all hope to do sometime. But we don't have now, it's a season. How do we make this? How do we like walk this season? How do we make this season? So buy these kind of things. You need one, buy a white, buy a black, buy a favorite color, and buy a color that suits your shape. Like for him now, he's deep coffee.
On the camera, yes. Is it for him?
He's deep coffee, right? You are like caramel brown. I'm honey. So, this is popping on my skin. It might not pop on the skin. I don't know. So you need to find your color or find your nude. Nude is the original white man. Again, we are going to refresh it, so I don't sound racist. But like, nude is the white man's neutral. The white man's word for neutral. Thank God that they are realizing black people are also existing. So we have to find our own nude. His nude will not be your like deep dark brown is his nude. Do you understand? Those are colors that he will wear in and he will disappear in. It's like wearing his skin. For people from Sudan, black is their name. You have your name. Everybody has their name based on their own skin. Find your name. Find a white. Find a black. Find your favorite color. Now, that's one.
Very important.
Another thing you should find out, at this type of shirt, these are, I call them, they are statement shirts, but they are shirts with things on it.
Okay.
You know? Find something that tells a message. Like it's cold, this is 16 naira. This is why I call this because of the touch. The quality is not that great. Okay.
So it's something just weird in this plan.
You get like three of them. Once it's done, you drop it. Yes. Yeah, that's what you do because it's just for now. So you wear it to class. Now how do you I can wear this to church. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that because it is disposable. You can't wear it to church. What I mean by disposable is
because of the weather,
the spring, and the fact that it's not so quality. You don't have to use it again and again. For your quality pieces, please wash them as dry cleaners. Again, they take a whole lot of money. You don't wear them often. You break them out in very sacred locations. Summer is not that hot. Summer, you are going to be changing clothes over and over again. Why? Because of the weather. If you are maintaining a good hygiene. You know, so you get lots of this kind of clothes. Make sure it's breathable. Make sure it's breathable. So you get white, you get again white, black, neutral, and the color you like.
You know,
they don't want to this.
Okay.
Thank you.
Sorry.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you very much. Round of just round of
this. Yeah, so this is an example of them.
Yeah, this one is nice color.
Yes. Now let's see. Your nude. Yes. See, it's her nude. It's her neutral. It disappears on her. That's what we call nude. Like that. Also, you need to think about color schemes. You need to find out as you go. These are the time, student times are the time for discovering what colors work well on you. Find out this stuff. Like you can have navy blue. I know what colors that no matter how I look, no matter how the cloth is cut, no matter how it looks, I will always look good in that color. And you need to be careful. It can work for you and against you. You can look at your wardrobe and you have, for him it's only green and white. Like when I look through his wardrobe, he has a bunch of olives. Why? Because it always looks good on him, no matter the cut. Whenever he wears it, he looks good. Watch out for that. You should.
But can you say that black and white can work for everybody?
Yes.
Black and white.
It can work for everybody. But then you should measure more on which one pops out on you more. But no matter what you do, you should have a black and you should have a white.
I think I said it last time.
Black.
Yeah, yeah.
Monochrome is. I mean, the world runs on monochrome. Because there are times when you don't want to keep washing. dedicated. White is really, really dedicated. I have blacks, like, you've got blacks in like seven different pieces, seven different cuts. Black, and whenever you wear black, you instantly look chic. Do you understand? That's why people say, when in doubt, wear black. If you're going for any occasion and you don't want to look odd, is it a date? Wear black. Wear a pop of color. For girls, that's like lipstick or paint your nails. We girls, we have all sorts of things. But you
even,
guys,
even for guys, like, even for guys, wear black. And wear black. White sneakers just work for almost anything.
So wear black, when in doubt, wear black. If you're going to church, you don't know to church, you don't know how to dress, wear black. A funeral, wear black. A wedding, wear black.
Oh no, oh, wedding. I'm joking, I'm joking.
Black is it. Yeah. But when do you wear white? When you want to respect the sanctity of the occasion. Or if you want to show that, yeah, you've got style, then you wear white. Again, it's a very delicate color. Meaning it gets dirty easily. So you need to think in terms of where you are going. Okay? That's it. You need to think in terms of where you are going. You are going to school. A white shirt, a jean, and a shoe. You're good. You can never go wrong on it. So you have to have your formulas. Like I have
so
my formulas.
The question I want to ask is, like, if you have, can you wear white on white? What can you contrast to the white? Because wearing white on white, it looks like you're going somewhere to perform or to you know, you understand what I'm saying? So
yeah.
What can you contrast for the people that want to know? Maybe they want to try a color on white on white.
So two things. When it comes to like trying colors and choosing outfits, it's a very complex thing.
Okay.
First, you have to have your go-to outfits.
Okay.
Go-to outfits are outfits that I have an exam, I don't care how I look, but I still don't want to look bad. So those are your go-to outfits. They are called capsules now. Meaning, you have white on olive, white on black, white on green, white on what? White on jean. Does not matter whatever the jean shade is.
Okay, yeah.
white will always work on jean.
True.
Throw on any shoe, throw on a sandal, throw on a boot, throw on anything. It will always work. Those are go-to. Now, if you're going for an occasion or you just feel like, I just want to be here, then you have to start contrasting. Then you have to take time in front of the mirror. You have to take time in front of the mirror. A t-shirt, it's not just the color, it's how you wear it. If I wear a white shirt tucked into a white trouser and I wear a brown belt on it and I wear pumps,
exactly.
I don't look bad.
Exactly.
Mm. Right? But if I wear white, tuck it in white and wear a white sneaker, I'm going for a golf suit.
Yeah,
so
crazy.
It depends on you need to be very creative with it.
Yeah.
Like if you're wearing an oversized white t-shirt, then you have to tie it.
Tight, okay.
Do you understand? Again, there's the power of accessories. Don't ever downplay it. Whenever you have, that's what you do for your go-to outfits. Like your mini, I know them. I don't have to think. Like, I never look bad unless I want to look bad deliberately. Yeah. And I'm reaching that age where I can't get away with it because I don't know who I'm going to meet. Maybe he's going to be interviewing me the next day in the job meeting. But like, for young people, you don't really have, for students, you don't really have a lot to like stress yourself about. Just have this go-to outfit. Jeans is a no-brainer. You need a jean. Done. Unless you're on the plus size, then you need tights. You need leggings. You need them. Staples of them. Not one. Like a whole lot of them. And you need to try them on. You need to know your body shape, your body type. And I used to think that girls were the only ones with, you know, you have girls who are heavy on the boob and they are like light at the back. You have girls who are like big at the back, light on top. You have girls who are like all of that. Pear, apple, rectangle, square.
Android,
you have for guys too. You'll be surprised. There are guys with broader shoulders and leaner hips. That's the classical guy. What I mean by classical guy is the guy everybody is used to. But that's not everyone. We have guys with hips. You'd be surprised.
Yeah,
there's my pastor. One of my pastors, favorite pastors, Pastor Michael Todd. He's got hips. You know? Now, for a guy that has hips, you can't be wearing skinny.
Yeah,
honey,
skinny
you're not going to be gay. Unless you are gay. Okay. In that case, much love. much love. You know? But for the guys who don't want to present a particular image of
what
they are.
Sorry, girl.
True.
If you have hips,
we're gonna do it right now.
You can't wear skinny jeans. Or if you wear skinny jeans, you have to wear a long top. Basic rules.
True.
Do you understand?
Then, sorry, let me just quickly add these two questions. What do you think about color blocking and matching colors? Can you tell us something about that?
Okay, so it's like this. You can always color block.
But color blocking,
it depends on the occasion. Is it
color blocking, does it pass more than three colors? What is the normal color you should keep?